you realize that these generations, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created us. Everyone, I was saying, has a story. You are unique. You are amazing. You are awesome. Allah knows your lineage going all the way back to Nuh alayhi salam, and you don't know it. So what would happen? It's Allah Almighty who will take care of you. He will. The only thing I am allowed to say to you is words that would encourage you to get closer to Allah. But I'm not allowed to belittle you, no matter what. I shouldn't. No prophet has belittled his people. Look at the prophet Lot. When he called his people, he told them, "Oh my people, why are you doing what you're doing?" For example, he didn't swear them and shout them and belittle them and so. No. Look at the prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, addressing mushrikeen. And what did he say? "Oh my people, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent the angels to listen to the instruction in Ta'if, when they were throwing stones at him, do you know what he said? Allahumma hdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. Oh Allah, guide my people, they don't know. Guide them. Oh Allah, guide them." Subhanallah. So these are the words that we should be using. And that's why I say, not just myself, even amongst ourselves, we use beautiful, empowering words, mashallah. Allah will bring you. Sometimes we struggle because Allah Almighty wants us to find Him. Sometimes He wants us to find Him, to shed a tear. Do you know that there are people in your midst, in your lives, in your communities, perhaps maybe even in your families, outwardly you wouldn't imagine that they are perhaps closer to Allah than you would have thought. And I'm in no way encouraging people to discard the goodness of their appearance, but I am saying, don't judge. You don't know what's going on. How many are the opposite, where you see them, they appear so saintly, and you find them engaging in behavior that is totally unacceptable.